I'm going to tell you about a specific little quirk with a keyword golden ratio. My name is Doug Cunnington. I'm from Niche Site Project. I talk about internet marketing, Amazon affiliate sites, project management, and sometimes really deep on keyword research. And that's what I'm going to talk about today. So if you remember, the keyword golden ratio is the number of all untitled results divided by the local monthly search volume, where the local monthly search volume is less than 250. If you don't remember that video, please go watch that one. It sort of breaks it down into a little bit more detail, a little bit easier to understand, but I'm gonna talk about why it has to be under 250 searches per month today. So the reason why is because the sheer math of it, right? So when you look at the search volumes that are 250 or less, when you look at the ratio of 0.25, that is 62.5, right? So the problem is when you go to higher search volumes, say 1,000, you end up with 250. So the sheer number of what you're competing with just works out that it needs to be 250 or less. What we're looking for here is like content that you publish and it immediately ranks as soon as it's indexed in Google, and it immediately ranks for the term that you're trying to rank it for. So the thing is, like, I mean, I get emails all the time. Someone will email me and say, hey, I found a great keyword golden ratio term. It gets 6,000 searches per month. And I think to myself, that's not gonna work because that means there are 1,500 other pages on the internet that you're competing with. And if you're, you know, launching a brand new site and you don't have, you know, any backlinks, it's gonna be pretty tough to compete with 1,500 other, you know, sites that are probably well established and they're already out there. They already have backlinks and stuff. So when you look at 250 or less, that means you're only competing with, like, at most 62.5, or if we round that up to 63, you're just competing with 63 other pages on the internet, and chances are not all of them are actually trying to rank for it and they just happen to be ranking for it. So at that point, you're going to be able to rank a little bit faster. There's just less competition when you look at the math. There's a secondary thing going on with this 250 search volume as well. So it's my opinion, I haven't tested this in an experimental way or anything, but as you go to higher search volume, say 500 searches per month or 1,000 or 10,000 per month, you're gonna find that it takes a little bit longer to rank for those. I think there's a lot of factors involved, but it's my opinion, right? My pure opinion that Google probably makes it take a little bit longer to rank for these higher volume search phrases. Now, inherently, there's more competition for those too. So I think that has something to do with it as well. There's more competition because it's a more profitable set of keywords because more people are searching for them. And it just makes more sense that there's more competition for, you know, more profitability. So that sort of makes sense to me. Again, when we look at, you know, if you're going to aim for a search volume of, you know, 50 searches per month versus 5,000 searches per month, I've seen just in general, it's easier and faster to rank for 50 searches per month compared to 5,000. Stick to the formula, and I think you're going to have better success with the keyword golden ratio. In the next video of this playlist, Alex is going to talk about how long the content should be when you're trying to do a keyword golden ratio sprint. Be sure to check out the rest of the playlist, and if you haven't, you know, seen the other preceding videos, be sure to check out the link in the description and, you know, watch this in a series. I'll send it over to Alex.